Well, good evening and welcome from Tannadice Park. We bring you all the live action on DUTV for the first home competitive game of the season. She's Dundee United, play host to visitors Elgin City in Group B of the Premier Sport League Cup. United kicked off their League Cup campaign with a Lauren Shankman goal. We saw the Tangerines return with the 3 points last Friday from Kelty Hearts, whilst Elgin City narrowly suffered a 1-0 defeat at home in their opening game to Arbroath, who face East Fife at Gayfield tonight in the other group match. There's a reduced number of fans in the ground and they're making a lot of noise for the first game since Partick Thistle. And it's now head coach Tam Coates' first competitive game at Tannadice. We're looking forward to that. Quickly going to the teams, United make three changes from last Friday evening. Out go Charlie Mulgrew, Callum Butcher and Ian Harks, and they're replaced by Ryan Edwards, Kerr Smith and Florent Haughty. A quick look at the teams as they line up. Gavin Price also making two changes to the Elgin City team. Out go Hoban and Sopel, and they're replaced by Thomas McHale and Brian Cameron. A change in goal there as Thomas McHale comes in. So alongside me this evening, Mark McCreary. Mark, first game of the season last week, you know, there's some ring rust to get rid of, but there was a lot of positives to take out of the game. I think during the game we were really extolling the virtues of young Flynn Duffy and Kieran Freeman on both sides as wing backs, getting up and down the park, and what a difference. You see the enthusiasm they brought to the game.
Yeah, Flynn on Friday was excellent. It was just unfortunately he had to go off. I mean, he kind of pulled up in front of us sort of late on in the game, just before he went off, and you kind of knew his night was done. But he was excellent. It was good to see the way he was getting forward and getting back in support of the defence, getting forward and in support of the attack. But the big thing for me tonight is obviously just fans getting back into the ground again. They're getting a really nice view of the pitch from the Eddie Thompson side of the ground, obviously in the bright sunshine, and we know that the sun will be right in their eyes, and that'll be a one for the whatever goalkeeper is facing into the sun first half. It'll probably cause a problem for the goalkeeper, certainly in the first half. You know, anyone that's been fortunate enough to play on Tannadice on an evening game, they know that at that end the sun always hits into the eyes of the goalkeeper, so it's one to watch for whoever wins across tonight. But the other big news, obviously Ryan Edwards coming back into the side as well. Unfortunately, United fans that are in the ground tonight, they won't get to see Charlie Mulgrew starting the game tonight. I mean, he was excellent last week, absolutely strolled the game last week, strolled the game against Brechin as well a couple of weeks ago. He's just been a joy to watch in the defence, the way he's just marshalled the defence and just been that calming influence on the youngsters around him as well. It's been a joy to see.
Yeah, also, you know, you could add in the clean sheet. We also, Lauren Shanklin back on target again. You know, we've been really looking to see Lauren Shanklin in that danger area of the opposition half. And, you know, as much as he's committing himself to the team and supporting the team, playing in a different manner, but we still, you know, when he's not in that box, we seem to lose that cutting edge and, you know, get the ball into his feet inside that 6-yard box, and there's only one place he's going to end up, isn't there?
Yeah, I mean, he done a lot of really unselfish running last week. I think Mark Connolly kind of touched on that when we were doing the commentary at Kelty last week. He's done a lot of unselfish running, taking defenders all over the place and creating space for others. But like you said, the place you want him to see mostly is in the box. And I think that was a feature of the two young lads either side last week, was getting up and trying to get the ball into the box. So hopefully we'll get to see a lot of that tonight on the Tannadice surface.
So a couple of three changes, Ryan Edwards, you mentioned there, but I'm also interested to see Kerr Smith as well. You know, we've seen a lot of Kerr last year. I think it was 9 games last season he played in. What for a 16-year-old, it's a fantastic amount. And Flo Haughty, who's had about a limited time involved in it, but you know, I think he's got potential in there, and you know, maybe this is his breakthrough season.
Yeah, well, we've seen Flo down at Kilmarnock towards the end of last season. He's one of these guys that puts himself about in midfield, and whoever he's up against knows he's in a game. So knows he's in a game. I think down at Kilmarnock he was coming for a yellow card on the totting up procedures.
Not long to kick off. It's a few minutes, 5 minutes or so. But in terms of what United have to do tonight, you know, they've started off with a win. A win tonight has got to be number one, obviously. But you know, a good performance sort of sets them up confidence-wise going into a tricky game come Saturday against Arbroath. They're playing tonight against these five. You know, really want to be going in there on the 6 points, yeah. The last time United faced Elgin was back in 2018, and you know, the only competitive game against Elgin, United won that comfortably 4-0 away from home. And Nicky Clark getting two, Adam Barton with a penalty, and Declan Glass had his first goal for United that day. And not so long ago, only two players in the starting 11 played that day, and that was Benji Sigurdsson goal. He'd taken over from Matty Rakovan that week, and that was the start of Benji putting a claim down for the number one position. He wasn't the number one at that time. And Nicky Clark, as I said, had a double, a brace there, and even with the penalty, he wasn't awarded the penalty. It was given to Adam Barton to tuck away. Not too much from that. Jamie Robson was also, he started the game, but he is not in the pool tonight due to the suspension. So not really much from 2008, still hanging around Dundee United, that played Elgin that night. Even the manager's changed. Shabba Laszlo was the manager way back then, and we've got Tam Courts now in for his competitive debut. Tannadice, he's passed his first audition. That was the competitive debut down at Kelty Hearts. A tricky, tight pitch. Came up with a result, and then the result in a clean sheet. United sitting on 3 points in Group B, just behind Arbroath, same points, but it's just a numerical advantage. Just waiting on the teams ready to come out. The league will be all the better this season for the fans being in and around 500 here this evening, and another 500 come Saturday for the Arbroath game. And then right at the back of that, with a bit of good fortune, we'll be seeing 2,000 or so fans in and around the ground. That would be fantastic. The noise when the players came out to warm up was fantastic, with 500 in the ground. It's going to be fantastic when United score in tonight's game, and looking forward to the future that visits and United back into league action. First game here being Rangers at home. Another cracker to look forward to. Just looking at the referee for today. The referee is Grant Irvin. He'll be assisted by Stuart Stevenson and Alan Granger. No fourth official named for this evening. Delay as the teams are in the tunnel, ready to come out onto the park. Just looking at the Elgin side, they've signed three players in the close season. One that was on loan and became permanent from Formantown United, Archie McPhee. They also signed Daniel Hoban, goalkeeper from Forfar. And Craig Little has signed from Stenhousemuir on a 2-year contract. Craig, a very accomplished centre half. We'll see him. A man of many clubs, Tony Dingwall, he's just signed a 1-year extension here at Ross County, and he is going to be one of the two Dingwalls that are on the park this evening, alongside Russell Dingwall, former Ross County youth player. As the teams get ready to come onto the park, Ross County already entered the fray. and led onto the park. And then we take the far side, the shed or Carling stand end, to get ready and warm up. United be led out by Captain Mark Reynolds. As he leads the players onto the park for this second fixture in Group B of the Premier Sports League Cup. And play host to Elgin. United have made three changes to the starting 11 against Kelty in their opening game. Out go Charlie Mulgrew, Callum Butcher and Ian Harkes. And in come Kerr Smith, Ryan Edwards and Flo Hawtey. United team will be Benjamin Segris, Mark Connolly, Peter Pollock, Nicky Clark, Ryan Edwards, Florent Hawtey, Kieran Freeman, Ron Shanklin, Kerr Smith, Flynn Duffy and John Dufoucks. Elgin will line up with Thomas McHale, Angus Naylor, Archie McPhee, Darryl McHardy, Craig Little, Rory McEwen, Russell Dingwall, Brian Cameron, Kane Hester, Tony Dingwall and Conor O'Keefe. Referee for today is Grant Irvin, ably assisted by Stuart Stevenson and Alan Granger. I'll be United to kick off. And Lauren Shankland perform that duty. The ball's played back towards Reynolds. He gets the ball back from Kerr Smith. Ball played over the top, too much for Lauren Shankland. Ball goes all the way through to Thomas McHale in the Ross County goal. First touch for the goalkeeper. Nicky Clark chasing down the fullback. He's playing the ball forward and a good header. Clear there by Ryan Edwards. And again, a header sideways to Mark Reynolds. And he allows his goalkeeper to have the first touch of the evening.
It's a lovely jersey that Benji's winning tonight, wearing tonight.
A winning jersey, you're right, let's hope so. Ball played forward, headed clear there by McHardy. John Dufoucks quick onto the loose ball. United knocking the ball about in midfield, looking for that space. Trying to draw out the Ross County midfield just to put some space in behind them.
I've seen a lot of that last week, just playing the ball along the back line, just trying, as you say, Dave, just trying to draw them out and the long ball forward there up to towards Nicky Clark.
Challenge there by Flo Hawtey quite strongly.
Yeah, well, we've seen them do that against Kilmarnock at the tail end of last season.
And the long ball forward there up.
Number seven there, Dingwall, certainly felt that one from.
Challenge there by Flo Hawtey.
Certainly doesn't take any prisoners in that midfield. All action. And robust alongside John Dufoucks is certainly going to be ball winners in there. Oof. And an overhead kick there from the edge of the box, hits the bar and goes over. Just came out of nothing. It looked like Ed was beating in the air. It's falling to Kane Hester and he just hit that one over his shoulder. And just came off the top of the bar and Benji was beaten there. United escape an early scare there.
Yeah, the first header, good header, and then as you say, the ball falls kindly there to Hester and he's an overhead kick there and it's come off the crossbar there with Benji beaten. Said before the game that the Sun would probably play a part in whoever was in that goal in the first half, but I don't think that was anything to do with the Sun. I think Hester just had a decent effort and he's cracked it off the bar. Nearly scared for United, but
great challenge there, gives Ross County a free kick in their own half.
Nice one, Kerr Smith there, winning the ball and then spin out to Mark Reynolds and start building again.
Yeah, Elgin just sitting back at the moment, just trying to draw United out as United were trying to do that ball over the top, and Hester's onto it first. He's got their little pool, but he still gets the ball. He gets it behind Benji Segris and the ball is in the net. Hester just on a ball over the top. He's quick. Quick over the yards. There was a little pull on him just as he was trying to face up Benji Segris, but he kept his position and he just calmly slotted it behind Benji. United go behind and only 5 minutes on the clock.
Yeah, decent ball forward there, right through the middle, and Hester's in there to get the shot beyond Benji Segris for the opening goal. Kersmith's trying to pull him back there at the edge of the box, but Hester's done well there to keep his feet and get beyond Benji and just slot it into the empty net to open the score on the night. And did have that little one just one or two moments ago, and then Hester obviously getting the opening goal tonight. It's not what we wanted to see, but just need to regroup and build again.
That's Elgin, two chances, a couple of minutes there. Hester hit the bar, didn't take the warning, and he's put United to the sword in only the 4 and a bit minutes. Smith back to Segris. Segris playing it long. This time, Lauren Shanklin coming back from an offside position. Elgin doing well there, just keeping a good line, getting up sharp. Goalkeeper taking the ball long into the corner. It's over the top and it goes all the way out for a goal kick. Sort of caught on the wind. Over the top of the attackers and the defenders. And they could get a goal kick. Champion unable to get that under control, but he wins the throw in. Just trying to send one down there for Kieran Freeman on the right hand side. Slightly overhit from the United midfielder. I'm going to get the chance to catch that one. Elgin again just trying to put a ball over the top, and Hester's through again. This time Flynn Duffy adding a bit of cover, but he's United eventually out. Scrambling a bit at the back, and Duffy comes away with the ball, plays into the feet of Shankland, who finds John DeFuchs. United get the ball under control, but again Hester's pace through the middle mark is really causing United all sorts of problems.
Yeah, well he's scored already, he's had that one off the crossbar, so obviously one to watch tonight, but hopefully we don't see too much more of that. And the rest of the game, the 80 or so minutes that's left of the game, see more United in possession of the ball and getting up the other end of the park and getting guys like Flynn Duffy on the ball and getting forward and getting the balls into Lauren Shankland and Nicky Clark.
Flynn Duffy can't get past his man, but it's enough to force him to play it into space, and it's straight to the space that Mark Reynolds is. Takes a return pass from Fuchs. Duffy just tries to flick that one round the corner. Shanglin does well to win back possession for United. Ball inside to Haughty. Haughty just playing that ball into Fuchs. He plays it, lays it off first time to Shanklin, but United lose out the ball and another ball directly through the middle. And Dingwall is beaten there by Kerr Smith.
Yeah, that was really nice from Kerr Smith there. Just read the run of the Elgin forward there and just well marshalled and gets the ball back to Benji Seagrass. Well played.
Next ball to the feet of Nicky Clark there from Mark Reynolds. Clark trying to get the head up to see who to pass it to, finds Fuchs.
Peter Pollock's obviously keep myself as an option there as a link man.
Nicky Clark again just trying to thread the ball through. There's not really much space here. Ball was on the way through to the goalkeeper.
Yeah, the Elgin City back line there very compact as you were driving forward. It's obvious early as you're watching it, you've seen Peter Pollock dropping short and trying to link up the play there. A couple of times there that Nicky Clark chose not to use that option, went inside to Jandal Fuchs and we get the ball forward. Well done, Flynn.
First corner of the game goes Elgin City's way. Came off of Flynn Duffy as he was trying to shield that one out for a goal kick.
Yeah, with Hester up front for Elgin, proving a real handful already in this game. And actually thought Flynn done well initially there and trying to shepherd the ball out for a goal kick, and it's just unfortunately it's bounced off his ankle and out for this corner. Do you think Elgin will take about half an hour to take this one? Already for getting the time wasting nonsense.
Yeah, so left back McPhee up to take the corner. Maybe another corner of the back post.
Yeah, Kerr Smith is always stretching for that one there. Maybe looking for one of his teammates to give him a wee shout there. I think that ball quite possibly would have been going out for a goal kick there.
Right footed in, Nicky Clark gets the header away. John DeFuchs helps it out again. Takes his time, finds Reynolds. Plays the ball up the line, can't find Nicky Clark. Hester again battling away there with Flo Haughty. Flo Haughty comes out with the ball. And I think first challenge strong, but he gets through that. Gets the ball down the line, but can't keep it in. Ball spun outside the line. Throw into Elgin.
Elgin seem to have done their homework. Obviously, getting an opportunity to see us against Kelty Hearts on Friday night there. It's obvious here, and Flynn Duffy's getting the ball there, doubling up and trying to stop that outlay.
Good battling there by Fuchs, he gets the ball wide. Again, United forced to come back deep, keep hold of the ball. Certainly that sun is causing a bit of discomfort there. The ball's coming to players, they're having to refocus to get the ball. Reynolds left footed. Switch the ball at the far side.
Good.
Freeman knocks into Fuchs. Inside to Shanklin, makes some space. These are coming back to him. Ball's taken away from him. And it's out off of Haughty. And it's out for off of Peter Pollock, actually. And it's out for a goal kick.
Yeah, Lawrence is unfortunately a good support player on the right hand side there from Kieran Freeman. And a good link up with Jandal Fuchs. Ball drops to Lon Shanklin, he beats his man, gets a shot blocked, comes back to him and tries again, and it just ricochets off of Peter Pollock and out for the goal kick. That's what you want to see. You want to see Lon Shanklin hitting the ball in the box, getting a shot away.
Yeah, he's got himself a yard to space there to get the shot away, but good block by the Elgin centre half. Down there, but Duffy there helping out, knocking it. Went on the overlap.
Unlucky again.
Certainly beat his man there.
Just running out of pitch room there. This
yeah. Scrappy there. Eventually the ball's overhit, the ball forward. No, Hester this time running on to that one. It went all the way through to Benji Seagrast. Good ball from Reynolds into the feet of Shankland. Does well, gets away from his man. Plays a lovely ball into Clark, gets it back. Looking to find Chandler Fuchs through there. Great save from the goalkeeper. Good chance for Fuchs as he turned on that one and managed to get his shot away. Goalkeeper does well to smother it. And it runs out for a corner to United.
Yeah, great link-up play there again. Nicky Clark, Lauren Shankland plays in Chandler Fuchs. Lovely wee turn from Chandler, but then the ball just runs away from him slightly and gets the shot in anyway and for this corner.
Reynolds did. Edwards did get the header there. Comes out the Fuchs, plays it wide. And Duffy alongside Haughty, gives Haughty the over pass, gets whips across into the back post. No one's there for United. Elgin City skipper clears up the line. Kenneth Smith loses out there. Hester running through the middle, just waiting to see if he can get a pass there from Dingwall. He's forced to turn away. Good possession there from Thunder Fuchs, but Dingwall just a team shot into the hands of Benji Seagrast in the end.
Yeah, easy save for Benji in the end there. Dingwall, a lot of running there down that left side, always shadowed by Randall Fuchs. As already said, there an easy win for Benji, even with the low sunlight right in his face.
Elgin's getting snappy, getting quick in that midfield and allows Hester to run past Reynolds. And a touch there by Edwards just took that away from the incoming skipper. Almost had a tap in there. Cameron almost getting on to the end of it in the end. United trying to play that ball through, Shankland only a yard or so away from it. It's cleared. United have to recycle it through the midfield. Kerr Smith moving forward to add that extra man. Okay there, can't find Lynn Duffy. The wide pass and it's out for a throw in to Elgin City.
Yeah, just seeing that replay again.
Seeing that Hester. Run through.
Hester's have been a real handful for United tonight, and I think a better ball in from him. I think to Brian Edwards' credit there, he got a touch on that, but a better ball in for him. And we're looking at 2-0 at the moment. Fortunately, we've got that one clear. But the alarm bells are there. Hester's on a game tonight.
It's a bit flat at the moment. United need to. I need a spark from somewhere. Need to get a bit of movement. At the moment, it's Elgin has got the confidence, you know, hitting the bar and then scoring so early in the game. Their tails are up, and United need to work hard.
Yeah, we knew there'd always be a hard one tonight anyway, because it's essentially the Elgin's Cup final, is it, coming here playing against a Premiership opposition at a nice stadium on a nice night, so. It's up to us to take the game to Elgin and be in command of the tempo of the game.
another ball into the feet of Nicky Clark. He's got spins away, faces up the midfield, wide to Smith, who helps on to Kieran Freeman. Takes it back. Swinging into black and white shirts there at the moment. Can't find the space. Pollitt knocks this one down to Fuchs. He's got a chance to get the head up as well. Finds Freeman. Fires one in there. Oh.
Go on, Lawrence. There you go.
Ron Shanklin puts that in the net. The goalkeeper fumbled it. He's very sharp. Shanklin inside that 6-yard box. Took a touch away from the goalkeeper and just poked it into the back of the net. United get back on level terms. 19 minutes played here at Tannadice. Dundee United 1, Elgin City 1.
Yeah, you said it before the game, Dave. Get the ball into the box. It's not even half a chance for Lorne Shanklin. It's, as I say, the keeper's fumbled it. He made a big zero of that one, but Lorne Shanklin just gets on the loose ball and just has to stab it home to get the equaliser. Hopefully that'll settle a few nerves. It's obviously been there in the last wee while. Yep. Another good finish from Lorne Shanklin, doubles his tally for the season so far. Yep.
And Kieran Freeman doubling his tallies for assists. He fired that one in the cross, and you know, first time we've put one across the face of the goal and the goalkeeper's fumbled it. So that is maybe the spark I talked about just a moment or two ago that United need to get themselves back in this game. Let's take this to Elgin City.
Yeah, and it may only be 500 or so United fans that are in the ground, but they certainly made the themselves heard above the echoes of the tannoy. That Lorne Shanklin tune.
Again, Hottie does well there. Wins finds John Doe Fuchs. Clark into him, but it's a hard one to take and he can't keep control. Yeah, but a good step in there from Flynn Duffy. Gets United back on the ball. Very tenacious, isn't he? Doesn't seem to want to give it up at all.
Yeah. Yeah, he was excellent on Friday night at Kelty. Enjoyed to watch on Friday night. It's good to see that energy in the side, but went to temper it in the latter stages of the game, because he obviously tired in about that 60th minute or so, 60, 70 minutes.
Composed there from Kerr Smith to bring that down on the knee and look to pass it. Takes the ball again from Edwards, advanced into the Elgin City half.
Elgin are quite content to just let us sit and have the ball. They're not sort of chasing and pressing and harrying as much until it gets into that sort of final third area. Obviously conserving some energy as well for themselves. It's going to be a long night for them.
Again, as soon as Elgin got control of the ball, they're just playing an early ball. They're trying to get runners in behind United, and this time United have set up slightly different because Edwards took a step back, so you had an extra yard to go and see that ball and easily outpace the forward. A wee touch there from John DeFuchs just deflected down to the path of Peter Pollitt. Just enough. Good ball into Nicky Clark on the run. Good strike, but always rising. Came out of his foot.
Yeah, it's good to see though, just getting the ball forward. Sometimes a quick ball forward presents an opportunity. It's a bit far out, but we've seen him hit them from there before. This time it's gone over the bar into the shed behind the goal there. But good again to see the run off the ball from Lorne Shanklin, giving Nicky Clark that option should he want to just thread it through into the box for him.
The game seems to have slowed down a little bit. It's a hot night. Early season.
Yeah, I think Elgin got the lift from that early goal and
put a lot into the first 15-20 minutes.
They've seen opportunities for getting behind, so full credit to them for throwing everything at it. And obviously we've got the equaliser now and should hopefully get a foothold in the game and just stamp their authority on the game more now that we've broken the scoring duck.
Coming from the right hand side. Back there from Shanklin to Pollitt. Oh, he allows that to go under his foot, but a poor touch. Sees Dingwall give them opportunity to win that ball. Hester plays the ball down. Again, as you see, Ryan Edwards just that yard off, and he's quick to get past Cameron there and win the ball.
Good again from Elgin there, the ball that Brad Dingwall won in the middle of the park with a meaty challenge against Horty. Elgin break quickly, but Ryan Edwards, to his credit, read that really, really well and got the possession back for us.
It's nice that Freeman came into the inside, allowed the space on the outside. Pollock went and took the ball, now United are further up the park.
Ball
Pollock goes on to the lock. Nicky Clark.
Well played.
Nicky Clark just dinks one over the top of the goalkeeper. What a flick there from Peter Pollock. He started the move way wide on the right. Cut inside. He played off a great pass to Nicky Clark. It was almost stopped ball for Nicky just to come into it. Little dinked ball over the top of the goalkeeper. United take the lead. It's Dundee United 2, Elgin City 1.
Yeah, it's a lovely finish from Nicky Clark there. Nice ball up here from Mark Reynolds. Good way to pass, but just a wee cute back heel inside there from Peter Pollock, and as you say, Dave, just a wee lift over the goal, the advancing goalkeeper, he's sold himself very, very quickly there to Nicky Clark, and Nicky just lifts the ball over into the empty net to make it 2-1 Dundee United. Very, very good finish there from Nicky Clark, excellent finish.
Tom Courts will be feeling a little bit more settled now. United have got a grip of the game. Managed to sort out the back in terms of the way Heston was just running beyond them on any long ball, and now concentrating, we've dominated the midfield and we're making chances and taking them. It's all coming together at the moment, but you know, still a lot of work to do. There's a lot of the game still left.
Yeah, you know yourself, Dave, when you're playing against the so-called lower teams and lower league teams in a cup tie, they always come out firing on all cylinders at the start. That's that sort of early momentum from other teams that you have to cope with. We certainly didn't think we'd be going behind so early on and facing up against a spirited Elgin side. It obviously affected nerves a wee bit in that point. But we've settled down nicely and just grew into the game. And those two goals obviously help massively, don't they, with the nerves and the confidence.
Yeah, it's a little bit of a bite back, even though we've not played fantastic football, we've played good football, we've worked our way back into the game, and you know, two great finishes from Shankland and Clark, top goal scorers from last season, and you know, that's what you're looking for.
Yeah, I thought it was good to get your recognised goal scorers on the score sheet as early as possible in the season. Sometimes games like this, sometimes they're really tight and cagey, other times it's high scoring games where your sighters get plenty of goals, a couple of doubles or hat-tricks or whatever. But good to see both of them on the score sheet tonight.
Throwing down the line finds Tony Dingwall. Up against Ryan Edwards. Gets a cross into the back post. And
well done, Benji, that's a foul.
Benji falls over. Kieran Freeman, I think, and he's taking a knock there as he went to take that high ball at the back post.
I thought that ball was in Benji's hands there before the collision.
Yeah.
You can usually see these kind of decisions going the way of the goalkeeper. It's a lovely cross coming.
Dingwall just puts this one into the back post. He thought it was overhit. Yeah, I'm sure he could blame Hester for that. He's going there, and I think he's came out. If anything, he's not challenged, and that's probably been the problem for Benji there.
I think he's actually collided with Kerr Smith there as he's clutched the ball. Then on the way down, it's come out of his grasp. Thankfully, there's not been another Elgin goal into the score sheet tonight.
Ball played up into the corner there for Pollock, just eludes him. Yeah, put a throw in.
And Peter there saying maybe should have played it further wide for Freeman to run onto and then get Peter into the play. Excuse me.
Shouldn't be surprised that Keane Hester scoring, because he's got 41 goals and 78 appearances for Elgin City. It's quite a remarkable turnaround for him, ex-Arbroathman.
That's a decent start. You've just pulled out of nowhere there, Def. But it's opportunities for guys like him to put himself into the shop window, see what he can do against a Premiership side, so that'll do. His chances are a move away from
great
the
ball.
Elgin City. No harm at all. Great ball and over the top there for Freeman to run onto.
Dingle there, and great challenge there, but it looked as though it came off the ankle of Dingle there, but the referee decides it's not, it's a Elgin ball.
Good tenacity again, and the same challenge.
Yeah, difficult to call, I suppose.
Go either way, that one could.
United again, just trying to build up slowly from the back, pull out the Elgin midfield forward, just a little bit of space in behind, drop those balls into Nicky Clark and Shanklin, give them a bit of space to work in.
Again, Elgin just quite happy just to sit back and allow us that possession. They're just shuffling across, not really putting any pressure on the ball when you've got it in the back line. It's just when it's getting that wee bit further forward, they'll start pressing a wee bit more.
Right, just working it to the left hand side, and Nicky Clark just trying to put one up the line, intercepted. Out for a throw into United. Edward just finds Kerr Smith. Freeman into Haughty. Again, United forced back to the halfway line.
I think Elgin are trying to force us into going long, but they're just quite content to just keep possession. I mean, there's no real urgency for us to get the ball forward as quickly.
You get the runners from Nicky Clark like that, he lays one off, John DeFuchs takes it, finds Flynn Duffy, takes it back from Duffy. United up that 20 yards further up. Long left-footed pass there from Mark Reynolds, it's cleared for a throw-in. Shankland out there. Freeman taking the throw-in.
I was just watching Benji there as well. He's up doing a David Marshall. He's up near the halfway line a minute ago. Ah, well played. On you go. On you go.
Oh, Nicky Clark should be finishing that. The goalkeeper saved it with his feet.
Oh, you're not,
back to
Shankland
and a left footed. Half volley goes fizzing past defenders and goalkeeper alike. Clark can't put it in, but Shankland certainly does. It's the third goal for United, 31 minutes on the clock. Dundee United 3, Elgin City 1.
Yeah, I think the Elgin keeper thought it was his birthday night tonight. Two point blank double saves there from Nicky Clark's efforts, and his strike partner just does the need for me. It's great play by Nicky Clark to create the space for himself. You've got to think that he's scoring there, but the keeper does his best to block the efforts, but he's certainly not blocking that one from long chance. That's a great strike.
Yeah.
They get 3-1.
Again, United going close to adding to the score, but goalkeeper kicks it long. Reynolds gets there first for Hester. Hester guesses right and he almost intercepts Benji's pass back to Reynolds.
Just that third goal there, Dave. That quality feat from Nicky Clark to just create the space for himself. He'll be really disappointed when his efforts didn't go into the back of the net, but great for Lorne Chantlin to get two already.
And Nicky Clark just playing the ball into the feet of Shanklin, who wriggles past, players keeps the ball, and United are able to rebuild it again.
Ah, oh, well played. Flynn Duffy there just fouled after he popped the ball through the legs of Dingwall, I think it is.
Yeah, he's taking a knock. Hopefully, all be okay soon. United it's a free kick. Nicky Clark and Peter Pollitt standing over it.
And Duffy's still feeling the effects of that challenger. Seen a close up there shot of him grimacing.
Back post, and there's Reynolds into the back. Illegal, says the referee.
Yeah, I think Mark was just guilty of having both his hands on the defender there as he's climbing for that knockdown.
As the fans applaud the substitutes out behind goal, Benjamin Seagrass is at. Seagrass this time forced to come out of the box there. Again, just trying to build that through with Pollitt. It's Freeman again, wide on the right, no chance of going up the line. That's blocked off, forced to come back.
You get a sense that United has just tried to up the tempo, just ever so slightly, or just trying to get the ball moving through the midfield and into the wider area. It's just that a little bit quicker now. Third goal's obviously settled any sort of nerves that they may have had after that first goal went in early on.
Edwards back to Seagrist and the United goal. Shielding his eyes from the sun there. Long with that one now. Wide to Freeman out for a throw in now. Challenger. Pollitt finds Shanklin, tries to play one over the top. Fixes there, gets in behind the defender.
Ah, good turn.
Dingwall over there, just gets the ball away for a throw into United.
Yeah, just unfortunately from Freeman, great turn in the box, trying to create a wee bit of space for himself to get into a cross there.
Ah, well played. What a dummy. Shanklin again, just trying to do the back heel. It's deflected away by the defender. Shanklin back heels inside the 6 yard box.
That would have been a nice way to seal a hat trick, yeah? Wee back heel over the goalkeeper.
Florentine United.
Seen that one again, good movement again in the box. Shanklin turns.
Holds behind them, just taking that. See them floating over the top of the goalkeeper's head for a, sure it would have been given as an OG, not a Shanklin goal, but Edwards on the right foot. Ball forward to Duffy, lays it off to Shanklin, and the first time shot from Shanklin tipped over the bar there. Corner to United. And Duffy at full stretch there to get on the end of that Ryan Edwards ball up. Edwards seeing the young left back off on his run. Falls over the top of the full back, and there's Duffy heading. You can see that Shanklin's looking for that hat trick.
Yeah, good to see him applauding Flynn Duffy there for the first time ball inside. It's good to see your striker as well, just hitting a first time effort. Great save from McHale in the goal as well.
United come forward against. Just build, build, and then try and find the space. That one over hit there from Pollitt.
It's a few times I've noticed Peter Pollitt making those runs in between the full back and the centre backs, just trying to create a wee bit of space for himself. And Kerr Smith's seen that as well, and just trying to lift it over the top for him to get onto.
Yeah, Pollitt's run was good, and Kerr Smith just over hit it, just couldn't get on the end of it. Edwards, because it was so compact, he just wanted to get a bit of clearance, and there was Peter Pollitt, the full back, and he just dinks one into over the top of McHale, and he could do get that fourth goal. 39 minutes on the clock. Peter Pollitt takes his time, makes sure, gets United that three goal advantage. Dundee United 4, Elgin City 1.
That's a cheeky finish from Peter Pollitt there now, isn't it? Sometimes that just works, does it? Just a big ball up the park. Defender's got to do better there, but Peter's done well and just won the challenge. Faces up to the goalkeeper, McHale, and just dinks it just either side of him and into the back of the net. A cheeky wee finish, but I think McCarthy's got to do a bit better there. And good strength from Peter, and finds himself in front one-on-one with the goalkeeper. And nice wee finish. He's been making a lot of unselfish runs, as Peter, all night, and we've not been able to find him. That's just taking a big lump up the park, and he's just chased it down and won the ball for himself. And we're 4-1 up.
That ball goes over the top of Freeman. He goes inside, and Pollitt tries to find the wing back. As you mentioned earlier, Segris is playing well outside his goal now. He's playing like that keeper sweeper position, helping out Reynolds.
Got a credit Dingwall there, just wasn't giving that one up on Mark Reynolds. Thankfully the presser just came off, and it's just a throw into United.
Into midfield and Hawtey.
That's a nice pass there.
All over the top, just wouldn't it? Looked as though it had pace on it.
I thought he just clipped it right into his path there. And over it, ever so slight there. Good idea though, just trying to find the early ball out to Kieran Freeman to drive forward.
Fast approaching the halfway, half time, 41 and a half minutes gone. Right, Pollitt again with the overlap, Freeman turns inside. And Smith does find Freeman. 1-2 with John DeFuchs to Hawtey. Elgin sitting back, as many men are seeing what's going to happen if they leave gaps. Martin Clark again, this time it's Reynolds marching forward. Funduffy's cross is knocked out for a corner to United.
Very good play there from Mark Reynolds. They're just stepping forward onto the ball. Nice wee skip past his opposite man and then out for Funduffy to cross into the box and we get this corner.
Ball played in, just skims past Kerr Smith, I think, and it's out for a throw on the far side. It came off of Kieran Freeman last.
Yeah, it was a nice drilled cross from Peter Pollitt there after a short corner. Just looked inviting for a head just to get on the end of it. It was just 50-50 challenge here with Freeman and Little.
Carl's just playing one over the top. Put it down there.
Oh, go on again.
Pull that, intercepts again. Just the wrong side of Shankland. Run out for a goal kick, but United quick to intercept here through Pollitt.
Yeah, he's onto that quick as a flash. Good pressure from him. Winning the ball high up the park. And trying to play it down the line. I think it was to Freeman again. And just overhead it slightly and it was out for the goal kick. But obviously, Peter's playing on a bit of a confidence and a bit of a high after scoring that cheeky effort a short while ago.
Yes, they're bringing it down, but didn't keep hold of that, and John De Fuchs has pulled back. He's trying to go for that 1-2.
Yeah, it was a clear foul on Fuchs here from McEwen. He's fired right into the challenge here. It's just as John Doe was getting away from him.
Final minute of the first half. United comfortable. Reynolds wide to Duffy. Nicky Clark can't get to that one. It's knocked out for a throw-in. No, United high up the park.
Yeah, I think Flynn seen Nicky making that run, but just as he was playing it, Nicky actually checked back out of the run. We get back up the park as well and get this thrown. I thought it'd been knocked out of play. Good mark. It's a foul.
Clark as well, just gets it under control. Could have went either way to Pollitt if it went through, or Shankland, but United very fast in playing that forward. Fast approaching half time, and half time appears from the referee's whistle. United had a shock at the start. First of all, Hester hit the bar after 3 minutes and scored after five, and United really looked as though they were vulnerable at the back with balls played over the top, and the speed of Hester and the quickness of getting the ball from back to front was going to trouble United. But they rejigged, they got control, they blocked that, and they came back with four goals of their own. One, Shankland with two, Nicky Clark with one, and Peter Pollitt getting the fourth. Puts United going in at half time leading by 4-1. Mark, apologies for the start of the game. Had a bit of a brain freeze.
What?
Brain freeze.
A brain freeze there. Okay.
And I was looking at something. One of the players was a Ross County, I do admit, one of the players was a Ross County youth player, and I was going to mention it.
Is that and that's Tony or the other Dingwall?
Daniel McCarthy. But anyway, that said, apologies for anyone listening who didn't try and convince you it was Ross County. It is Elgin City we're playing to something.
Ah, you're all right, mate, it's fine.
So
you get through it. Yeah, I don't think anyone would have seen that start from United tonight. I was a bit shell-shocked at the start there, but you never want to see your team go behind. I mean, particularly like for the 500 or so fans that are in, I mean, yeah, it's the first time they've been able to see their team in 18 months or whatever it is. It's it would have been really difficult for them to take as well, particularly being at that end of the ground.
First goal down that end, yeah.
I mean, Hester, he gave us a warning shot with the one off the bar, and then, I mean, it was a bit of a nothing pass after Edwards had put the ball into the middle of the field and we'd lost possession, and a quick ball over the top, and Hester's, you've got to give the guy credit. I mean, he was onto it in a flash and gets forward and gets the effort away.
So here is that first one, 3 minutes gone, and ball just comes to Hester, and he just speculative, but he certainly knows where the goal is. One over the shoulder, and you know, on another day that drops in, and United are goal down 3 minutes.
Brian Edwards last season was winning that ball all the time. It's the first one I think I've probably seen him miss in the air, and then Hester finds himself in a nice pocket of space and tries a speculative effort overhead and off the crossbar. I don't think Edwards has lost a ball all night since. He'll probably be a bit frustrated that he lost the first ball, but maybe expecting the second one to be picked up. But you've got to give the guy Hester a bit of credit. He's found himself in a nice area. You're not expecting him to hit that shot from come that way and it's come off the bar, but then certainly the opening goal.
That was the warning, Mark. That was the one we should have took heed of. But, you know, within a couple of minutes, another ball played down the middle and off went Hester. It was under a bit of pressure from, I think it was Kerr Smith. He got back there. You know, I think if he had went down there, Kerr might have seen a card or certainly could have been off. But give Hester his due, he saw it and he's managed to keep control and just nudge that one behind Benji and it's in the net and they've got the lead after five.
Yeah, I mean, Ryan Edwards doing what you're expecting them to do there. Unfortunately, it's went to an Elgin City man, but to their credit, they've put it over the top. It just caught out the other two at the back. He's got all that space to run into. Kerr's tried his best to get back onside and get in front of his man, get in between him and the goalkeeper. And just at that point, he's got a wee pull on Hester. Again, to Hester's credit, he's put a nice finish past Benji in the goal. You weren't expecting it at the time, but then you move on and get a foothold in the game and get some goals and get the strikers on the score sheet.
Yeah, well, United have been battling for that 10, 15 minutes after that goal to try and get back in, and you know, when you're looking for a goal, there's only one man you would turn to.
There's a couple.
Robin Shankland, and he's got United back on level terms in 19 minutes, and think, you know, the quickness of thought. He's in there when the goalkeeper fumbles this good ball in first time, and Shankland's in, he doesn't give it up, he doesn't think the goalkeeper's got it, and he's turning away in disgust. He's right across, and he's sniffing out goals inside that six-yard box.
Yeah, I mean, it's a good ball in from...
Mistake from the keeper.
From Kieran Freeman. And it's like post, I mean, you're expecting either one of your strikers to go the back post, you want another one to make a run to the front post. Both chose to go to the back post this time, and Kieran's put it into the front post, but the goalkeeper's kind of fumbled, but Lawrence has done what every good striker's done, or does, sorry, and gets onto the loose ball, and it's a really nice finish from Lawrence. Just quick to react, and get in there and just easy finish in the end for him once he's got himself into that position.
I think at this point, Vicky Clark finished top goal scorer last season, and he's probably thinking, as Lawrence got two, he'll better get moving here.
Yep.
Within 5 minutes, he's got himself on the score sheet.
Yeah, it was a nice finish as well. Ball comes into Mark Reynolds here, and he plays it up to Peter Paul, and this is a really nice touch, and the runoff from Nicky Clark, and then the awareness to know where the keeper is. And the keeper's really sold himself very early on there, just rushing off his line. He's got his two centre halves just a yard either side of him as he's come to the edge of the box. And then it's a cute finish from Nicky Clark. It's not easy to do, I wouldn't imagine, under that sort of pressure. He's not got all that much time to make up his mind. It's a good instinctive finish, but the keeper's really sold himself there. But we'll take it 2-1 up at that point.
Exactly, and United thinking, you know, we're on top, let's go and push this as far as we can go. And, you know, Shankland again thinking, I need to get further away from Nicky Clark. So, you know, after Nicky.
At this point, Nicky's saying,
Nicky's thinking, I'm going to get level
here. Couple here. Yeah, again, it's Potty there just playing the 1-2 with Nicky Clark just shuffles inside the defender. And got to say, I mean, the keeper, he's throwing everything at it and just blocking those two efforts from Nicky Clark. He's probably thinking, I've done my job. And then the loose ball falls to Lauren Shankland, and he's just not finishing that. He's not saving that one. Great effort from Lauren Shankland, ripping into the net with a good effort.
Yeah, two good saves from the goalkeeper, and I'm sure Nicky must have been thinking, oh, this is a glorious chance to get a third goal, and he sees Lawrence just smash that into the net, and I'm sure he'd be more than happy as his strike partner get his second goal that evening.
Yeah, it's good to get Lawrence on the score sheet. He got one on Friday night, he's got two tonight so far. Probably fully expecting him to get a hat-trick now tonight.
And if those goals were all good football and good awareness, you know, the third one is a bit more, shall we say, we took advantage of the situation.
Right, sometimes, like, I mean, Ryan Edwards clearing the ball, he's not trying to play Peter Paul in or anything like that. It's just we're under a bit of pressure at that point. He's hoofed the ball up the park, but Peter, to his credit, the big defender, I think it's number four McCarthy.
Yeah, the Ross County Youth Club.
Yeah, number 4 McCarthy. You would think he should really be dealing with that one there, but Peter Paul, to his credit, just pressurises the situation, wins the ball, and it's not an easy finish in the end. It's, I said at the time, it was a bit of a cheeky finish from Peter Pott. Lovely finish. He's, sometimes strikers get spooked when they're in this situation, when they're just facing up to a keeper that's advancing on them like that, but Peter just chooses to just dink the ball over his right, the goalkeeper's right shoulder, and it's into the back of the net.
Well, you know, obviously, you're right, the centre-half should have done better, cleared his lines, but the goalkeeper did, for me, did everything right. He stood tall, he didn't go commit himself too close, he didn't stay on his line to make
it
easy.
Yeah, that's what I mean by spooking the striker. Sometimes the strikers maybe think, well, I'm not really quite sure what to do here, but Peter, to his credit, just found a pocket by dinking it over him into the net. I thought it was a lovely finish.
Yeah, right there. Yeah, and just would have been icing on the cake, or even the cherry on the top of the icing. Later on, Sean Shanklin had another chance, the long ball from Ryan Edwards, and Flynn Duffy does well to get a touch on it, to put it back in, and Shanklin don it in a flash, looking for that hat trick. Great ball there from Edwards. Duffy does enough just to help into the box. Left foot, full of confidence. Great save from the goalkeeper, toned for the earlier mistake.
Yeah, I mean, Pete Pollock's goal was a courtesy of Ryan Edwards just hoofing the ball at the park. That was a more cultured one into the corner. But the awareness from Flynn Duffy, as you said, Dave, just the first time ball inside the long Shanklin. Long Shanklin does everything that he should do. Just hit it first time, but probably got the credit of the goalkeeper with a nice save there. Probably a decent height for him to pull off the camera effort.
I think in one of the goals, I think it was the Mickey Clark one where Mark Reynolds went forward and played a lovely ball into Peter Pollock, who'd started the move on the other side. You know, that ball from Reynolds was outstanding.
Yeah,
and you picked it up in the commentary. I thought, you know, an excellent ball, you know, from the composure just to play an easy ball. He could have hit it hard and, you know, put it into the box, but he didn't. He played it right into the feet, and it was a great finish. Great to build up. So, you know, in terms of the way we started the game to the way we finish, you know, United will be disappointed to lose, you know, a goal so early in the game, but I'm sure they'll be more than happy that, you know, we've got back on track quickly, we've got a grip of the game, and it's really only the long balls over the top that's causing United any sort of any discomfort. And United have dealt with the last few because they've rejigged at the back and given Edwards that amount of space to go and win the ball, and Keane Hester's not been nearly as effective as he was in the first 10 minutes or so.
Yeah,
he's still a danger, but, you know, not as effective as he was.
Yeah, I mean, you said it early on in the game, Dave, it's difficult sometimes when you're playing in these cup ties against the lower league opposition, because if they get any sort of sniff to get in front, which they did, sometimes they can just sit back and be, it can be so frustrating to break down, but to our credit we've come back into the game, and not just got into the game, we've come in by a long shot, 4 goals in the first half.
So we're going to have a short break for 2 minutes. The camera's got to be reset, and we'll be back online in 2 minutes. A chance to get rid of these Ross County notes. thanks for rejoining us. Just technical rebooting of one of the cameras. We did a full switch off. So Mark, you know, we just mentioned there, I think, you know, will it be time for some changes, do you think, in terms of tactical or even given some of the players that have not, I'm thinking like Ryan Edwards or Haughty, or just to make sure they don't overdo it tonight and they get back into things. It's, you don't want to cause any injuries too early on.
I suppose we're in quite a fortunate position just now. Being 4-1 up at half time, it gives you an opportunity to maybe tinker around with things that you may or may not have already thought about before the game. I mean, why not give? We're all about giving guys from the academy a chance, so there's every opportunity that they'll get a chance tonight.
Certainly looks like Callum Butcher, he's got the training top off and the strap, so it may be that Ryan Edwards is probably a week or two behind the rest of the squad. 45 is maybe enough for him and to get him back into things.
Yeah, and again, because we're so well in front in the game, it gives head coach Tam Coates the opportunity to take Ryan off of his, if he feels he's maybe had enough of his legs tonight, just to keep them ticking over, as you say, Dave, get him ready for like the first Premier League game of the season and get him fully fit. So obviously he did miss a week.
Yeah, just we've seen a Butcher waiting at the side of the park to make his entry for the second 45 minutes. No other changes that I could see. United just making that one change. Yeah. Elgin City players still not back on.
Yeah, I think Callum just going in there. Ryan Edwards was in the first half, and Callum played on the right side of a back three on Friday night, so it's obviously in the plans to just put him in there as well. If maybe Ryan was tiring or whatever later on in the game. But obviously, taking the opportunity to do it at half time.
Yeah, I heard in his pre-match interview, it was about, you know, being injured and missing the start of the season last year, and you know, always seemed to hinder him, and then when he did get his injury in the first game, it set him back, and you know, you just don't want to see that.
To be honest
again
with you,
to the big man.
To be honest with you, I mean, looking at Ryan last season, certainly, I didn't see any sort of hindrance in his performance there from missing out on the start of the season. I thought he was an absolute rock in the back line whenever he played last season. Very rarely he would lose an aerial duel or a one-on-one or any sort of attacker running at him. Very accomplished defender, and one that you like to see in your side more often than out your side. I actually would have liked to have seen him in with alongside the Cameron influence of Charlie Mulgrew tonight, but Charlie's on the bench.
Yeah, I think, you know, you're looking at Butcher coming in, and he's going to do the, for me, he's going to be the one that'll step into midfield and become the additional midfielder and allow these two guys to be a bit more concentrated on the defending.
Yeah, I think obviously the fullbacks will enjoy their second half at this time. They're running down that slope towards the United fans, and hopefully they'll give the United fans a chance to.
Substitution for Elgin as well. Cooper came on, centre half. Elgin gets us underway. Ball just trying to find space up there. Ryan McCardy drifts out, thrown to United.
Elgin keeper still hindered by that low sunlight.
So I'm just trying to let that pass behind them to go to Paul, that was cut out. Daniel back.
Well done.
To McPhee. United get in there and get on top of it. Haughty striding forward again. A touch that goes loose and allows the challenge there, and the ball spinning dangerously inside that box.
Yeah, I think goalkeeper just kind of lost it there in that sunlight. See the challenge coming from Hottie, and it spun way into the air.
Kick up there, Dingle hips on. Reynolds forward, Shankland takes a touch back to Clark, immediately fires it forward to Pollock, who's beyond Shankland again. Shankland, one touch layoff passes, keeps the ball moving. Reynolds has to be quick. Puts this well inside. Freeman helps it down the line. Shankland forced McCardy to go and play it. Don't think he really wanted it. He wanted to see that one out, but Freeman wins the throw-in for United.
Ah, oh, well played.
Again, another one-time pass there from Shankland. You can see that the ball coming to the two front men. They're just playing it and going round behind. They're spinning behind, just trying to take the return pass. Full back McPhee beaten to it there by Kerr Smith. End of it. Push it back to the goalkeeper. Hardy to McPhee, runs into trouble there. Again, a step over from Shankland. But McCardy positioned that right and he caught it, taking a pace off it with the chest and the goalkeeper's hands.
Yeah, you see that moment or two ago, Dave, the link up and awareness of the two strikers up front, it's good to see, and it's a joy to watch as well. Just them trying to create a bit of space for himself with the movement and touch up front.
Stem long ball over the top again, but Benji out the edge of the box just to thwart any danger. Plays the ball into Peter Pollock's feet. Just comes back. Segrist plays it long. It's headed wide to Freeman. First touch from Pollock's always to get it out of his feet and get moving, isn't it?
Yep,
gives him that yard or so to get away. Just didn't work that time.
Yeah, you can see what they're trying to do though. They're trying to get the ball into space early and link up. Yeah, just on that occasion with Peter, just unfortunate, it just fell to the Elgin left back there.
The throw into Dingwall, but it was a bit high for him even to try and cushion it back, and came with Hardy and he just had a slash at it. It's out for a throw to United.
Two balls on the pitch.
Balls on the pitch.
Oh, go on.
Nicky Clark, loose ball.
With a run from Duffy.
Oh, look at that. Fired in. United almost capitalising on that. A loose ball. Nicky Clark gets it. ball eventually makes its way out to Flynn Duffy, and he just fires it in a hard and low. You know, could have found the United foot.
Yeah, it was very early on in that move when the ball was loose and Nicky's on it in a flash, but the support from Flynn Duffy on that left-hand side, and Ron Shankland then picks him out, and the ball's in the box, crossed early, and out for this corner. Good support from Duffy, really good.
Cross, not cleared yet, bouncing about in there. Reynolds twice had a go at it, but this time it's Freeman that puts it back in. It's nodded on by Ken Smith, but beyond Nicky Clark. It's a little push there by Hester, well spotted by the referee.
It's an easy one for the ref there. Hester has been actually very quiet since that early passage of play early on in the first half. Good ball.
Good diagonal. There's Nicky Clark in there, first two players beside him. Still gets the ball into Duffy. Just needs a wee touch into front of Peter Pollock, but he's dragged it alongside him. He's kept control. On the front foot, finding Hottie. Oh, Hottie through ball, and there's Shankland.
Oh. Ah, that one was tight.
The flag goes up, the dreaded flag.
That was good play from United once again. I mean, the ball from Flynn Duffy just hit there, was just slightly behind Peter Pollock. Had to kind of recycle it again. And nice threaded pass there from Callum Butch, I think it is, and the path of Lauren Shankland.
Just a yard or so.
Yep. He's done well though, rounds the keeper, no bother. Slots in an empty net, but no hat trick at the moment for Lauren Shankland. I think I've done Flo Hottie a disservice here. It was him that put the pass through, it wasn't Callum Butcher.
Butcher, towering header. Again, just a ball over the top, looking for scraps at the moment. Elgin, they're just trying to get back in the game.
Good big early shout there from Benji, with the ball over the top, and he's out commanding his area really, really well.
Nicky, great spin away from his marker. Pulls him down, but he's up, ready to challenge again. Great into the feet. Shanklin's looking for this time.
Go on.
Scott Freeman on the outside. Oh, what a goal for Kieran Freeman. Lauren Shankland took the ball, controlled, heard the shout from Freeman on the outside. He's delivered the ball for Freeman to hit hard and low. It's clipped the post and went to the net. United get their fifth goal of the evening. It's Dundee United 5, Elgin City 1.
What a nice finish from Kieran Freeman there. A typical fullback finish, really, is it? Yeah, good play. Nicky Clark all over that build-up there. And nicely threaded ball into Lauren Shankland. He's shown good composure, holding the ball up. Then there's that run from Kieran Freeman. And he's got one thing in his mind, and just fire that ball into the back post. And it's in off the post and into the net for the fifth tonight, Dave. I mean, Lauren Shankland could have just cut his man inside there and sealed his hat-trick, but just decided to give it to the youngster. And he gets his first goal for United.
Assists and goals, goals and assists. That's what makes the world go round. The football world, anyway.
Yeah, good, delighted for Kieran there. Got on the
social. Yeah. Reynolds' header just goes up, but Hottie there helping out. Gets the ball back under control. United back in possession.
I'm going to keep a close eye on Kieran Freeman. I think he'll be flying after that one. I think he's up there again. He's looking for another one. The build-up play to that.
Yeah, I think there's a problem with the ball. That's another ball soft. That's been replaced already. That one, you can hear it thudding. It's crisp. That's going to be the third ball in the space of couple of minutes on the park. He's taking one from behind the goal, I think, Benji. United just dragging the Elgin midfield back a bit, all over the top. Goalkeeper coming out, just making sure Jando couldn't get the ball, and eventually having to put it out for a corner.
I think the goalkeeper thought he was getting this no problem at all, but then realised it's Jando Fuchs he's up against. There's only one outcome when you're up against Jando Fuchs, and it's
United preparing for another couple of substitutes. See Chris Mochrie and Lewis Nielsen coming on soon.
Yeah, I think they'll come on after this corner, Dave. But good again from Chando, a really unselfish run there to win the ball, to win this corner.
Oh, look at that. Nicky Clark. Smashing it right in the top tier of the stand. So, end of the night for Lauren Shankland.
Oh, no.
Two goals and an assist.
No hat trick for Lauren
Shankland. He'll be replaced there by Chris Mochrie.
Just seen that corner there again. There, nice corner in from Peter Pollentag. Really nice area. Nicky Clark just gets the laces through and it's up into the top. And Eddie Thompson.
Lewis Nielsen. We'll replace Kerr Smith.
Ah, it's good to hear the applause again, just the guys going off and being appreciated by the fans. It's just great to hear again, is it?
Yeah, it's good to be back in it, Mark. Football's nothing really without fans.
100%. I mean, did you see the guy that clutched that effort from Nicky Clark? He was delighted to get a touch on the ball there. Top.
Smokery's first touches. Put the ball out for a throw in. Well stepped in there from Reynolds. Ball falls to Pollitt. It's ball down the line. Mochrie gets there first. John Doe a bit short there for Fuchs and he ended up fouling Dingwall. Enough from a pass there, and John Doe just trying to recover. Ball down the line, cut out. Duffy, and again, headed, clear. Tenacious fullback, always seems to be in the middle of it. Ball's there, he's there looking to get on top of it.
Ah, well played.
Paul,
that's clever.
Looks out to Freeman.
Place at the moment, Dave, aren't they? Just pulling them everywhere. They've barely had a sniff this half.
Yeah, we're moving the ball so quick. It's not giving them a chance line up, and that ball goes over the top. We just needed McCarty to get the header on that, take it away from Nicky Clark, who's making that dart through the middle.
Yeah, lovely ball over the top there from Jando Fuchs, and as you say, Dave Hardy just gets the touch back to the goalkeeper. Otherwise, Nicky Clark was in for another. Oh, shot.
Yes, they're down for a free kick. I think the D just outside the United box. United just a little bit sloppy there, had a chance to clear it and didn't. Now we're trying to get back in the game.
It's a good set piece opportunity for them. See what they've got here. It's in a nice area, quite central, just at the edge of the box.
Dingwall against Seagrist here. Not much of a competition, I think.
No, I was just, I was actually laughing there, giggling at, I think I heard Carl Bush, just take it in the face, take it in the face. Basically telling his teammates just to stand tall in that wall and just accept it. But the effort goes high and wide.
Another substitution for Elgin City. Keith coming on. Again, the step over, not working this time.
Work this time, though.
That's a great ball inside there.
Go on. Oh, good, good. Yes!
This time, United get a sixth goal. Chris Mochrie coming in at the back of Nicky Clark and get on the end of that cross from Freeman. Excellent pace on the ball, great position, and just needed that tap in. United get their sixth goal. Dundee United 6, Elgin City 1.
Yeah, what a lovely ball played through by Peter Pollitt, and the determination of Kieran Freeman to go on the end of it and play that lovely pass into the box. And there's Chris Mochrie, just his academy teammate there, just getting on the end of it for a tap in. But a lovely, lovely cross from Kieran Freeman and a nice finish from Chris Mochrie, hammering it home for the sixth.
Yeah, Chris Mochrie, he's been away on loan at Montrose, a lot of good reports back for him, probably didn't play as many games as he thought he would have because Montrose have been flying, but you know, coming back, gets his first goal for United.
Yeah, really well played, good build-up play. The ball from Peter Pollitt was inch perfect, but the determination from Kieran Freeman to get on the end of it and play a really nice cross into the box, a low cross. I think Nicky Clark was desperate to go on the end of it, but it's gone beyond him and fell nicely for Chris Mochrie to slot home.
Yeah, goal and two assists for Freeman to add to his assist Friday evening.
He enjoyed that goal on Friday night.
Yeah. No, he think he knew what it meant, didn't it? It was late into the game and, you know, to get that breakthrough on Friday. But tonight, even though we had a bit of a blip in the first 5 minutes, certainly came back with a bang.
Ooh, keeper. He just doesn't like being under pressure at all, that goalie. I think he wants to feel like he's a centre half, a ball playing centre half or whatever, but as soon as he's under any sort of pressure, he's is there a few nervy moments?
Pack of cards. He's getting involved, you're right. Bringing a bit of excitement to those fans behind his goal.
I don't know why he doesn't just put his foot through it there. He's trying to turn back in on a forward that's seen that many, many times over the years.
Quick throw out there, Paul takes it, cushions it. breaks away from him a bit. Nicky Clark, Buck, gets United in possession. Calm and composed, Lewis Nielsen there.
It's good to see as well, if there's not an option on, you know, you can just go back, just keep possession. No, there's not any rush to sort of to get forward, and just keep possession, just play it through. No bother.
Nah, they're willing to take the ball when it's in tight positions and go again.
Look, nice.
Amazing, great football from United out from defence.
Well,
Freeman
done.
Finds Clark. Clark trying to find Mockery again. Comes to Freeman again, dinks it in. United just not getting that little break there.
Well done. That's what she'd have done all the other times. That was really good play there. So unfortunate that the final ball there from Nicky Clark didn't get through.
John DeFoot's on a run with O'Keefe as well. And another couple of substitutions for United. Ian Harkes and Finn Robson coming on. Replacing Flo Haughty.
You know, it was great build up then. Good link up, just the running off the ball as well. Great run there from Chris Mockery, just beyond Nicky Clark. Nicky Clark then just tries to thread the ball through, but unfortunately just cut out by the Elgin City man. Yeah, but just really nice play, just really composed and just keeping it along the back line, and then at the right time just driving forward, and driving forward with purpose. It's good to see.
Peters is on for Elgin as well.
Oh, well done, Chris. It's a bit cynical, that one.
Just taking his ankle there. Have a quick word from the referee. Again, wide. Mockery just taking it in. He's just posting in there with back to Harkes, and he tries to return it to Pollitt. Can't get the same technique as Pollitt in. Like Duffy goes flying in there.
Jeff had everything there in that last 30 seconds. Some really nice player down that left side. Great touch from Peter Pollitt, laying it off for
Harkes. Tries to do the same, and
he's trying to do the same, and then Flynn Duffy then just goes, I'm having that. No matter what.
Okay. Nah, shouting to take the ball under pressure and pass it again.
You know what, it's the
running. Robson just on, and he's controlling things in the middle of the park.
Yeah, it's the running off the ball. Getting pressure. I see Lewis Nielsen there. As soon as the ball went back to Benji Segris in the goal, he just bursted out, making an angle.
Yeah, they know where to go, right? Keep the ball moving.
They're all making that.
Another ball, nice. There's Finn Duffy on the outside, and good challenge here. Yeah. Come back off of Duffy, he's looking for the corner. If he decides otherwise, but Duffy's taking a knock. You know, they've made their five substitutions.
Hopefully none too bad then, he can get up from that, but good determination again. It's a nice ball from Chris Mockery, finds a runner, Flynn Duffy. It's a good challenge in the end from the Elgin City man, but to give you a nibble on to Flynn as well.
Yeah, solid challenge, wasn't it? But he's still running yet, yeah. And Duffy, after a couple of bruising games, a lot of effort on Friday night, and then tonight again. United definitely on the front foot. They've certainly got themselves back into. I don't think there was any panic in the whole ranks, but you know, they did have to step up a gear. They were not on top of things like they should have been. Allowed Elgin a bit of a free hit early on, and they took advantage of it, and United need to get themselves back in the game by work rate, and then also take the chances when they came, and they've certainly come. So,
yeah, just seen that challenge again a few times on Flynn Duffy. Great run from Flynn, and a nice ball from Chris Motley, but thankfully Flynn's got up and he's all right now, and it's just move on again once he gets back on the park. Just down to 10 men at the moment. He's just run off after a bit of treatment.
Test their kick out there from the goalkeeper. Full back run right across here.
I think this is the most possession that Elgin has had in the second half, is it?
Yeah. And look what happens, they're just now hitting it along and there's no runner. Reynolds comes out, Duffy in the feet of Pollock, leaves it off to Harks.
Good one, Mickey.
There's pace on it. Greenland as well to get that bouncing ball under control.
Nope, that was out. I don't think that was out.
Close. It's going out. Throw into Elgin. Trying to keep the ball rolling.
Very hard to see that.
Good layoff there from Nicky Clark. He's pulled back as he's done it, but United keep possession. Okay. To Harks. Wait to Duffy. He's pulled back the way. So United could keep possession, keep the ball, keep it moving. To Pollock. Just one round the corner. Robson.
He likes them, doesn't he? Runs around the corner.
Done a few the night, hasn't he?
It must be so difficult to play against as well. Because he's got that ability to put it either side. And
Nicky Clark just holds on that one off and just gets a little knock. Can't find the attacking Freeman. Suppose you can be when you're six up, but you know, they're still showing that application. Okay, just pushing the back, you're playing that back to Reynolds. Good knock by Clark again. His goalkeeper got in his box of tricks this time. By Butcher there. Ball eventually comes to Mockery. He's through the middle this time instead of going wide. And he can get the turn on it. Oh, that little dink ball in there. Robson up helping. Mockery comes back to Freeman. He's put one to the back post. The other wing back wins the corner for United.
Yeah, it was a big high looping cross here to the back post, and Flynn's done well there to win this corner.
Good quick ball into the feet of Pollock, back to Duffy.
Nope.
Keeps the ball in the park, but no United player there. Needs Freeman to come out and challenge.
Well played.
Again, Robson watching the ball, making sure he gets a challenge in there. Could well have been. Nielsen battling there, getting the ball in. The Elgin man.
No.
Too much.
Again, just leading up to that corner, Dave, the movement in the box was phenomenal. A great run from Finn Robson, found very well by Chris Morphy. Really, really good player.
just looking up. Duffy's got acres of space on that far side. Starting to drag men over. It's making space for other players as well. Elgin find it very difficult to mark. United just now.
Ah, well played.
Again, played quickly. Nicky Clark off, looking for it. Ball's put out for a throw-in. Another one of those inside the legs and finds Harks. He's off on a run now. Freeman.
That's nice.
That's his third one of the evening. Two goals on the last one. No one in there for this one.
I was choking for someone to get on the end of that. That was a really nice
Duffy
balls.
Comes in, returns with the ball. Comes back and Pollitt's slaloming his way through there, but can't get the last touch on it. Ball into space. It's Peters. He's running forward towards the United goal. Can he get the ball in? He can't. It's cut out by Butcher. And the second time it's cut out by Reynolds. A corner.
Yeah, good break there from Elgin. Ball into the area up that right channel. First cross blocked, and then the second one's out for a corner as well. So
just going back to that, Kevin Freeman again, another dangerous ball across face of the goal.
Yeah, that was inviting right across the 6 yard line. Up a really good pace as well, in a really good area.
Exactly. And I'll be sitting in that dugout saying, "I wish I was on."
Mm-hmm.
Climbing there, like centre half. Little.
Big centre half, Little. Is that Sid, yep. Is it? No, showing my age now, David.
Yeah, you are. Dingle coming back and getting the ball, but Lewis Nielsen again winning the ball. Need to just losing a couple of passes there that going astray.
Yeah, you could see what Ian was trying to do there. He was trying to feed Nicky Clark in for.
Oh, good ball there, Mochrie. Glancing past the defender there.
Really good play there, great run from Chris Mocker.
Oh,
he's on.
Peters is through, and on Benji. Great save. Saved by the big man.
Oh, well
and
done,
a deflected yeah. Over the bar there by Lewis Nielsen. Great first save from Benji Seagrass, and it came back to Peters, and he thought all I have to do is hit this into this open net, and Lewis Nielsen gets there and deflects one over the bar. That's a defender, it's 6-1 up.
Well, seeing the lads in a similar position to Peter Pollitt in the first half, and you've seen what he done. And Benji's out smothering the area. Great save, and then what a block from Lewis Nielsen to put over the bar. Tremendous. Seen that in the first half with Peter Pollitt, you seen what he done to score a goal.
The corner coming in.
Good header.
Yeah,
great
what
save.
A save. It looked as though Little's header was going to go in there, but Seagrass, what a save. United come out from the corner with it.
I don't think Little could have done anything else other than put it into that corner, but it's a big hand that Seagrass has got into that. Excellent save, but good header, really good header, good delivery, good header, good save.
United again just keeping control of the ball, making sure they keep the ball moving. This time Finn Robson first pass of the night that went astray since he's came on.
Oh, that's
another bad challenge, and again. Okay, coming in for a bit of stick. Going to be two changes for Elgin City. On come Lawrence and Allen.
Just looking at that chance, the corner coming in again. Good leap, good header. What a save from Benji Segris there, eh?
Amazing. United's free kick just inside the Elgin City half. Dropping shot to collect that one, playing that one off. Nicky Clark is there, just couldn't get it. He just needed anything on that. The goalkeeper well out his box. Nicky Clark had a just had to get a touch beyond the goalkeeper.
Yeah, that was a nice ball over the top there from Ian Hartson, just that little bit beyond Nicky Clark and into the goalkeeper's possession there, but great run from Nicky Clark up front again, just spinning in behind the centre half, keeping himself onside and getting himself into an area to get onto the forward pass. Brilliant.
Good quick feet. Brought down again. Duffy.
It's been kind of a feature the whole night. I mean, the sort of blend of the team since we got into the game and got ahead. It's just been a joy to watch. The experienced guys just showing up well and just the energy of the youngsters, it's brilliant.
Just playing the ball so quickly, moving it, always on the move themselves, it's a joy to watch.
Oh, that's good again.
Again, the ball down the channel finds Freeman on the overlap. This time he's looking for Nicky Clark.
Oh,
not again.
Oh, it
looked like Ian Hart was going to be on the end of that there. Matt Reynolds, everyone shouting, shoot. Flint Duffy does really well to get beyond these the defenders, gets his shot away. Good save by the goalkeeper.
Yeah, I think that would have made the night if Mark Reynolds fired one into the top, Benny. Flynn Duffy, so unfortunate not to get on the score sheet there. Good save from the keeper, but you expect him to save it at the front post with that shot. But good effort down. Nonetheless.
That's great, nice. Ball wide. Finds Duffy. But the skipper plays one at the feet of Mochrie, gets one back quickly, gets out his feet again. Amazing.
I don't even think that pass was meant for Chris Mochrie, but he adjusted his feet so well there. I think the pass was originally meant to be going for Tannadice Clark there. Freeman's away.
Freeman's won it through the middle, isn't he? Feels a goal in him. Ian Hart's shouting for it there, but again another one just tipped round the corner, and Mochrie this time is glancing, looking for the box, so calm, so composed. Takes the ball again, oh, another kick of the ankles.
Elgin obviously see Chris Mochrie as a threat. Every time he's getting on the ball, he's being chopped left, right and centre. But to his credit, he's just standing up and slaloming through them all. It's
good athlete, the kid. He's doing well.
Good temperament as well. Others could certainly throw themselves to the deck, look for a free kick or whatever, to his credit, he's just keeping the ball. He's toying with them at the moment.
Nicky Clark almost getting that ball away from McCardy, but it does fall to Finn Robson. Parks. Freeman's on the outside, playing it inside too. Came to Robson at the end. Yeah, energies will be low for Elgin City players now. You can see that they're struggling to keep up with the United players. Ball played in there from Mockery to Pollock, comes back again and wide to Freeman. Good slash out of there from Pollock. Felt the wind there from that shot now.
That's unfortunate from Peter. He's got all the flicks and fancy tricks on show tonight, but the fresh air ones, they're always funny to see. Fortunately, we're 6-1 up to the good just now, so he can do that all he wants.
United having enough, and Harkes puts the ball back, put Seagrass in a bit of trouble, he's forced to make a save. Again, this one just flicked up in the air, but allows Butcher just to get a bit of pace on it. Comes all the way to Duffy, well under control now.
Yeah, we've dealt with that one well. Don't think Ian Hartzell will look back at that one very fondly, I don't think. I'll credit the Benji though to stand up to the shot.
Again, United just playing little boxes there just to get around the Elgin players.
A different test on Saturday though, and Arbroath are the visitors. I don't think we'll get as much time on the ball as Elgin have let us on tonight. I mean, it's been really nice to see once we got our noses in front and just being really composed and calm in possession. I think we'll see an Arbroath side that'll be kind of more in our faces a bit.
Yeah, I'm sure Dick Campbell will have his side well organised and well up for this, just like he always does when he comes here.
Yeah. But you can't take away anything from the guys tonight. I mean, it's been a really nice performance. I really enjoyed watching some of the attacking play tonight. Really, really good.
Ball back to McCardy. They're trying to build it from the back. Elgin.
Good night.
Nicky just putting the press on there and
does he hate
creaked a little bit.
Nicky still got the energy to press that bone. Try and get another goal. It's good.
Really can't see a ball pass forward there from the Elgin City back line. They're just looking for somebody to hit and there is no one. And the referee has enough of that. He's seen enough for tonight. He blows final whistle. United comprehensively in the end winning the game by 6-1. Probably the best first half getting back into a game having went behind to that early goal from Kane Hester. United returning back with two Shanklin goals, and Nicky Clark goal on a Pollock before half time got United back 4-1 ahead, and two goals in the second half from Kieran Freeman and Chris Mockery. You know, Freeman a goal and two assists tonight. It's building on from great performance on Friday evening. I think all the academy graduates who played tonight performed a high standard and certainly merited their inclusion in first team squad, and not only that, on the park of play. Been a fantastic show from United. in the end thoroughly deserved the win. Look forward to Saturday against Arbroath. As you mentioned, commentary, Mark, it's going to be a much more difficult game, and we'll look forward to that come Saturday here at Tannadice.
Yeah, I mean, we said already, Dave, we enjoyed that. I mean, after the early scare, we put that one to bed quite early on. I mean, 4 goals in the first half, you can't ask for any more than that, than the lads to turn things around. And then since they turned it around, just some of the football on display tonight was a joy to watch. I can't deny that. And I just thought, just the link-up play, the experienced lads really blended well with the youngsters that we've got on the side. The youthful energy and just the running and the enthusiasm from Kieran Smith to get on the end of that Peter Pollock pass for Chris Mockery's goal. It was good to see him. He put a number of good balls into the box. He put the low one in for Lauren Shanklin to get the first one in the first half. He'd done a couple of them as well in the second half. Really, really good to see. I really enjoyed just watching. Flynn Duffy didn't get forward as much as he did on Friday night, because I think Elgin had done their homework on him, and to their credit, they kind of nullified that a wee bit. But as the game progressed, he got more and more involved in it. There was a couple of times he supported on the left-hand side. Just when the ball wasn't even coming to him, he was in the area as an option. Good to see, really good to see. And I think the fans that got in tonight as well, the 500 or so, got to see a decent spectacle. And as well, they got to see their team score again, instead of sitting watching it on a laptop or however they're watching it all through last season, listening to us guys kind of ramble on a bit. But no, good to see this, really good.
Just looking at the scores in the other game in this group, East Fife have been defeated, or they're well on the way to a defeat. 93 minutes gone in that game, just about finished. It's 2-0 Arbroath, goals from ex Dundee United man Dale Hilson and Luke Donnelly with a goal in the 89th minute, tying off, and he did have Callum Ansell sent off in the first half. And there was another game in Group F. Stevie Lawless scored the one and only goal for Motherwell against Queen's Park in the 15th minute. So United will be happy with the situation, got the ship righted after an early collision. It wasn't quite Titanic against an iceberg, more a bump in the ocean, and back on track. Looking forward to that clash against Arbroath, also on 6 points. United go top of the league from the tonight's result on goal difference, but we will be looking forward to that battle with Dick Campbell's squad and Ed Lichty's when they come up on Saturday afternoon. So from myself, Dave Hall, from Mark, we are just about finished here. We've seen the last of the goals from this evening's game. Look forward to more. I should have kept a couple of these goals for Saturday. Kieran Freeman just slotting that one in at the far post.
Yeah, I mean, it's like we said, Dave, it's good to see. I mean, just rattled off a few results here. It's always tricky, these cup ties. You never know which way they're kind of going to go. But after the early scare in the first half, we got a foothold in the game and just never looked back since that. This is a nice ball here from Peter Pollock. Great pass, but the determination from Kieran Freeman to get on the end of it, and a nice low pass across the 6 yard box, and Chris Mockery's on there to get his first ever goal for United. Brilliant, absolutely brilliant to see. Kieran was good all night as well.
Yeah, Nicky Clark just inches away from getting his second of the evening, and Chris Mockery finishing it off. So just about finished here, as I said, from Mark, myself and all at DUTV. Hope the goal fest was to your liking. And
not quite a 6-2, Dave, but can't always have 6-2. Them.
Not everyone gets 6-2 from United. But 6-1, and upwards and onwards to the clash at the top against Arbroath on Saturday. Thanks for listening, and hope you can join us on Saturday. Bye for now.